NFPA 70B is a standard of the National Electric Code that covers preventive maintenance of electrical, electronic, and communication systems and equipment. The purpose of the standard is to establish an electrical maintenance plan and a condition of maintenance for electrical equipment and systems, all in an effort to improve reliability and safety. The standard states that electrical equipment shall be maintained in accordance with the manufacturer's instructions and applicable codes and standards. In the absence of manufacturer's instructions, NFPA 70B also provides guidance on the periodic maintenance procedures for most equipment categories, including low voltage breakers, protective devices, transformers, switchgear, and many more. These include frequency and procedural guidance for visual inspections, cleaning, lubrication, mechanical servicing, and electrical testing. Proper maintenance of electrical equipment is the responsibility of the owner, and there are both safety and compliance risks associated with not having a maintenance plan. From a practical standpoint, NFPA 70E, which is the standard for electrical safety in the workplace, requires that specifically overcurrent protective devices are properly maintained per 70B. This is because incident energy levels calculated in an arc flash study would assume that those devices, such as circuit breakers, are operating correctly. Should one of those devices not be properly maintained, there could be higher incident energy levels than calculated and expose the employee to greater safety risks and the owner to greater liability. From an enforcement standpoint, OSHA can enforce NFPA 70B under its general duty clause, where failure to properly maintain creates a recognized hazard. NFPA 70B states that the equipment owner shall implement and document an overall electrical maintenance plan. The plan has 9 elements that should be included. They include things such as a survey of existing equipment, planned maintenance procedures, a process to implement any corrective measures, identification of the responsible personnel, a record retention policy, and an overall program review process.